लेफ्टिनेंट कर्नल सरजाद आली जाहिर पद्मश्री से सम्मानित अलंकृत पाकिस्तानी सेना में उस समय लेफ्टिनेंट कर्नल रहे, लेकिन इसके बाद इन्होंने तय किया कि वो सेना में तो रहेंगे लेकिन आजादी के मुक्ति दूत बनकर, और इन्होंने मुक्ति वाहिनी की मदद की 1971 में और पाकिस्तानी सेना छोड़ दी। क्या इनकी कहानी है? बांग्लादेश के गैलेंट्री अवार्ड से लेकर भारत के शीर्षस्थ नागरिक सम्मानों में से एक पद्मश्री से अलंकृत लेफ्टिनेंट कर्नल साहब हमारे साथ हैं। आपकी ये कहानी बहुत इंटरेस्टिंग है और बहुत जबरदस्त है। कैसे आपने मुक्ति वाहिनी के सैनिकों को आपने ट्रेंड किया और कैसे बांग्लादेश की आजादी मुमकिन हो पाई आपकी वजह से? 1971 में भारतीय सेना पाकिस्तान तक अंदर घुसी, कैसे कैसे आपने इन्फॉर्मेशन इकट्ठा की और सारी इन्फॉर्मेशन को, पाकिस्तान की सारी तैयारियों को जूते के नोक पे रखा, एक बूट के अंदर रखा?
वेल, दैट्स वेरी इंटरेस्टिंग। फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल, द मुक्ति वाहिनी बॉयज वेर सो मोटिवेटेड, सो चार्ज्ड अप, सो फियरलेस, वी डिडन्ट हैव टू मोटिवेट देम एनीवे। हाउ? Because their mothers and sisters were being raped, their brothers and fathers were being killed, and it was a very tragic situation in Bangladesh. They are all prepared to fight, only they required the correct training of weapons and tactics, which we, the officers, were able to provide to them. And of course, in this process of training, it will be unfair to not to mention that Indian Army officers had great responsibility. We had in every Mukti sector, we had 11 sectors behind two. I'll come back to that again. It will be unfair not to mention the role of Indian Army in training of the Mukti Bahini. Lakhs of Mukti Bahini's boys were trained by Indian Army. Under their leadership, they had many training camps in which they provided them high quality training on tactics, battlefield movements, and also weapons. This training helped the Mukti Bahini to gain more confidence on their weapons and learn their tactics, especially guerrilla warfare, and they are able to attack the Pakistan army suddenly at night or in day and create such a big casualties for them that they had almost lost their morale.
Sir, 20 साल का एक जवान, एक अधिकारी, और किन इरादों को लेकर पाकिस्तान की सीमा पार करता है और आपकी इन्फॉर्मेशन की वजह से भारत की जय और बांग्लादेश की आजादी संभव हो पाई? कैसे मुक्ति वाहिनी के और आपकी भूमिका से पाकिस्तान को मुंह के खानी पड़ी?
एक्चुअली, war is a very complex situation. It is not only weapons, but the training behind it, which I already explained, that Indian Armed Forces give adequate training to Mukti Bahini boys, a great contribution. Number two is morale. The morale of Mukti Bahini was very high, and the morale of the Indian soldiers was very high, because they saw themselves the genocide, they saw the torture being committed on the common people of Bangladesh by Indian forces, and they were on the right side. They were on the side of justice, and if you are on the side of justice, your courage increases. With God in front of you, you are brave and you want to take challenges of life. That's only one reason. But another reason is to be on the right path. Indian forces were on the right path. They had no desire to capture the land of Bangladesh, which they have proved by returning from Bangladesh within 3 months of victory. They had no reason to loot, murder, or kill or rape any citizen of Bangladesh. They had only one aim: liberation of the country and liberation of the tormented people. And that makes your morale go higher and higher. The sky is the only limit.